Hi guys, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. I welcome you all in this video of Morning Tales, which is going to be helpful for your RBI Grade B, NABARD Grade A, as well as Grade B and SEBI examination for the Phase 1. Particularly, the questions that I'm going to cater here are going to be helpful for your Phase 1 of all these examinations. So guys, you already have heard that NABARD Grade A examination notification is already out. So this is your time that you should fasten your seatbelts and start preparing hard for the examination if you want to clear it. Okay, so let me clarify the very first thing for the NABARD students or the students in general, that for any competitive examination, you need to cover the current affairs of past 6 months. Okay, but if you have already covered the past 6 months, then I would recommend you guys to go further, go beyond 6 months, because we have already seen in RBI and in NABARD SEBI examinations as well that the organizations are not sticking to this rule of 6 months. They are going backwards. They are asking questions for beyond 12 months as well. So here your responsibility is that you have to thoroughly cover the 6 months before the date of the examination, and then you have to go beyond the 6 months, but the priority should be to cover 6 months thoroughly. Okay, so that should be on your priority list. Don't go beyond 6 months. Like if you want to prepare for the January current affairs, then I would not recommend it. But guys, prepare the first 6 months first thoroughly and then go beyond the 6 months. Okay, so that was the advice. Now here, second announcement I would like to make is the students who ask me about the PDFs. So guys, PDFs are daily uploaded on our website, Infinity app, which is there for you only. So you can go to that app, open the current affairs bundle, and there you will get all the latest PDFs. Apart from this, you will also get the latest PDFs on our website, currentaffairs.anujindal.in. So from there also, you can read out all the news that are provided on a daily basis. So that was all about the announcements. Let's begin today's video. But before that, if you have not subscribed till now, then do subscribe and hit the bell notification, because you know that examination has been announced. So we are definitely going to come up with various interesting as well as important sessions for NABARD grade A and B. Okay. This is the Telegram group. If you want to enjoy the quizzes that we provide on the group, or if you want to know about the latest updates about the examinations, then you can join this group. And the link of this group is in description below. And this is the course for RBI Grade B 2022. So I will be giving you a very brief introduction of the course. I'm not going to take a lot of time in describing this course. Okay, so quickly, let me tell you that PDFs, videos, mocks are available. Mock interviews are also conducted for you guys. And this booklet is also provided to you all. Okay. And right now we are running a 30% discount. If you want to avail that discount, use RBI30 coupon code. This is the number. If you have queries, then call us on this number. Our sales team will help you. Okay. So this is our first question about NABARD itself. So NABARD has recently launched some schemes in Manipur as well as in Kerala. But let me tell you, those schemes are not very important, because those schemes, you can say that they are the part of NABARD's operations. For example, promoting primary agriculture cooperative societies, giving grants for some research on vaccine for duck diseases. So these are some of the very basic operations of NABARD. But since NABARD has announced its examination, so there is no harm in spying on NABARD a little bit. So let's do the jasusi on NABARD now with this first question. Okay, so how many primary agriculture cooperative societies will be benefited by the comprehensive scheme for development of Manipur State Cooperative Bank Limited and PACS? Primary agricultural cooperative societies. So you have been given different numbers. The right number is 46. So 46 primary agriculture cooperative societies will be developed, will be provided grants, financial grant, so that they can develop their infrastructure, like their operating infrastructure, their office infrastructure. Obviously, they would have some kind of office. So in order to improve the infrastructure of that office, the software that these PACS use, so the grant will be provided through this Manipur State Cooperative Bank. And who is going to provide the amount to this bank? It is NABARD. So you would know that NABARD performs the refinancing purpose as well, that it provides the finance to the banks, then the banks further provides the loan or the credit facility to the needy people, to the farmers or to these kinds of cooperative societies. Now let's dig deeper into this scheme that has been launched in Manipur as well as in Kerala. Okay, so let's discuss this. But again, I would say that there is nothing much to it that you need to put your brains here. It's just a very basic basic scheme, a part of the daily operations of NABARD. Okay, so the first fact here is that these 46 PSCs will be given the financial assistance. How much assistance will be given? 10 lakh. Okay, and this will be given, 10 lakh rupees will be given to 10 PSCs so that they can strengthen their basic infrastructure. So this is the initial level. So initially 10 PSCs will be given the financial assistance, but in total 46 are being covered here. Okay, apart from this, two tribal development funds in Chora Chandpur and Faizwal. So these are the two districts where this tribal development fund project has been launched. So here nothing will be done except for promoting the horticulture based farming practices. So that is the function of this tribal development fund project, wherein the horticulture based farming practices will be promoted as well as better livelihood opportunities for the tribal people will be created. So these are the two projects that have been launched in Manipur. Now let's see how many projects and what kind of projects have been launched in Kerala. Okay, so first of all, the major fact here is that it's the 40th foundation day of NABARD. This is also important. You are the NABARD aspirants, if you are the NABARD aspirants. So this is the very basic mantra that you should be aware of. Kab established hua tha NABARD and by which act? Okay, this is your question that you have to mention in the comment section below. Okay, by which act NABARD came into force? Okay, so the first project that was launched in Kerala was this assistance that NABARD has given to this organization, Kerala Veterinary and Animal Sciences University in Thrissur. Why has this assistance been given? So that they can research on the vaccine of this disease, ramarolosis. Now this is a disease, this is a bacterial disease in ducks. Now here, particularly for the NABARD students, a question can be made, and that question is, what kind of animals contact this kind of disease? So this ramarolosis is the disease in which of the following animal or which state got the assistance from NABARD for vaccine research of this disease in ducks? So that there the answer would be Kerala only. But in which animal is this disease found? That is the question that you should know the answer of. That is ducks. Okay, so for NABARD students, this is important, guys. Next project is that 5 lakh assistance will be provided so that wireless connectivity can be provided to the tribal settlements in these two places in Mallapuram district. Again, this is not important. Nobody is going to ask you this because this is a very general day-to-day activity in which NABARD indulges. Okay, so this project is being implemented through Jan Shikshan Sansthan of Mallapuram with the support of Center for Social Computing as its technological partner, or it is going to be completed in 10 days. So before your phase one of NABARD, this project will be completed. It will be wrapped up. The third here is upskilling of young fishermen in the repair of outboard motors of the fishing vessels. So again, this is a very basic kind of project which has been launched in Kerala by NABARD. Okay, continuing with the third project only, for the training of 90 fishermen so that they can be skilled up so that they can repair the motor boats themselves, this organization has been given the grant of Rs 4.5 lakhs by NABARD so that they can conduct the training of fishermen. Fourth project is that four training programs with the assistance of 15 lakh so that they can acquire some skills under the state government for graphic designer program and Amazon Services Cloud program. So this much amount has been given to this program. So that is again another project of NABARD. So that was all about the projects of NABARD that have been launched in Kerala and Manipur. Now let's discuss the second question. Which of the following public sector organization is using the integrated real-time enterprise management system to digitize its operations? So you have Dedicated Freight Corridor Corporation of India, General Insurance Corporation of India, Pension Fund Regulatory Development Authority of India, National Capital Regional Transport Corporation, and Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority. So here the right answer is option D. National Capital Regional Transport Corporation is the corporation that is developing or implementing, we can say implementing, this iDreams system. Guys, full form is also important because it can also be asked from you, because it is a public sector company that is implementing this iDreams system. Now, what is the purpose? Why is this project being developed, or I would say why is the system being implemented by this National Capital Regional Transportation Corporation? The basic fact here is, or the basic function of the system is to digitize the day-to-day operations of this organization. Okay, so all the asset management, asset controlling, monitoring, or disposal of certain railway assets. So all these kinds of operations will be digitized on this system. So this is nothing but a platform that is managing, that is providing the service to this corporation so that it can manage its day-to-day operations on. So that is the whole purpose of this iDreams. So here again, I'm saying you, full form is important. Do memorize the full form. Moving on to the next question. Which company is developing India's largest single solar park at Run of Kutch in Kavada, Gujarat? Adani Green Energy, Tata Power, JSW Energy, NTPC REL, PGCIL. Which one is the right answer? The right answer is option D. NTPC REL. REL stands for Renewable Energy Limited. So this is basically a wholly owned subsidiary of NTPC itself, National Thermal Power Corporation. Now this is the largest single location solar power plant, which is going to have a capacity of 4,750 megawatts. Now guys, you should also be aware of this fact that the world's largest hybrid renewable energy park is also being developed in the Run of Kutch by the same company. That is, NTPC is developing the world's largest hybrid renewable energy park. What is the total capacity of this park? It is going to develop 30,000 megawatt of electricity. I used the word hybrid. So which kind of renewable energy sources will be used in this park? Solar and wind. I have taught you all these things when this project was launched, when the foundation stone of this project was laid by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Then only we had discussed all these facts, but it's just a matter of fact that you need to know how to relate the things. So it is the same place, the same company that is developing India's largest single solar park as well as the world's largest hybrid renewable energy park. Guys, NTPC is doing all these things because it has to attain its target of 60 gigawatt of renewable energy capacity by the year 2032. So this is something that I have come across many times in the newspaper nowadays. So you need to remember this thing, that NTPC's target is this much by the year 2030 in the renewable energy. Okay, so that was all about this question. I would like to ask a question from you. Bhadla is at present a solar power plant, and it is one among the world's largest single location solar power plants at present in India. Can you tell me in which state is this power plant located? So this is your question that you have to mention in the comment section below. Moving on to the next question. Which country is developing the world's first commercial small modular reactor? France, UK, US, Germany and China are in the options. The right answer is China. So the name of this reactor is Linglong 1 or ACP-100. So ACP Pradyuman Wala ACP. So this is the name. So Linglong 1 is one name and the other name is ACP-100. So these are the two names of the same small modular reactor, which is the first commercial small modular reactor in the world. So first of all, I would like to tell you the facts about this reactor. So this is going to develop 125 megawatts of electricity. ठीक है. And the next point of the next fact related to this is that it is a part of Changjiang nuclear power plant, which is located in Hainan province. ठीक है. So these are the facts about this nuclear power plant. Now, why is this reactor being developed? One reason is that China also wants to gain power in the nuclear energy sector. But the other reason here is that this small nuclear reactor is basically a jhanjatless reactor because it is very easy for to transport. China is using such small reactors for producing heat in the northern regions as well as for its desalination projects in the coastline. Okay, so desalination of water in the coastline. So this small modular reactor is way more easier to transport. Isko kaise bhi le jao, by aircraft, by ship. And sabse important baat here is that this small modular reactor can be installed very easily. Isko easily install kar lo, koi jhanjat nahi hai iska, and it can be transported very easily. So that is the reason. Apart from this, it is very eco-friendly. बहुत कम एनर्जी लेता है, वेरी लेस कार्बन एमिशन इज डन थ्रू दिस रिएक्टर, देयरफॉर इट इज वेरी एफिशिएंट एंड इट इज गोइंग टू बी दी नेक्स्ट फोर्टे फॉर चाइना. सो दैट वाज ऑल अबाउट दिस वर्ल्ड्स फर्स्ट कमर्शियल स्मॉल मॉड्यूलर रिएक्टर. बिकॉज इट इज मॉड्यूलर, देयरफॉर इट इज वेरी इजिली ट्रांसपोर्टेड थ्रू वेरियस मोड्स ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन लाइक एयरक्राफ्ट एंड शिप्स एज वेल. सो दैट वाज ऑल अबाउट दिस क्वेश्चन. नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. Which country will host the BWF Sudirman Cup in 2023? So let me tell you that it is nothing but the World Mixed Team Badminton Championship. So which country is going to host it in 2023? Thailand, Philippines, Singapore, Malaysia, China. China is the right answer. So this is going to be hosted by India itself in 2023, but now the BWF championship, world championship of 2026 has been handed down to India. So India is going to host this championship instead of this cup. Guys, remember that this Sudirman Cup is for mixed team championship. Mixed team championship is where one is male and the other is female. So that one team contains one male, one female. So that is the mixed team. Okay. The next point here is that this is the second time that India is going to host this BWF World Championship, the Badminton World Federation's World Championship. The first time that India hosted the World Championship was in 2009, where Hyderabad hosted it. Guys, this is another question that can be framed out of this news. For how many times has India hosted the BWF World Championship? So 2026 would be the second time where India is going to host this championship. And for the time being, it is only once that India has hosted this kind of world championship. So I hope that this much is clear to you now. Acha, there is one thing that I forgot to tell you, and that is the city where China is going to host this Sudirman Cup. So the city is Suzhou. So this is the city where this championship is going to be held. So guys, that was all about this entire question, about this entire news. And this is the time that we should say goodbye to each other. Thank you so much for watching the video. All the best for your preparation. Study hard and crack your examination. Thank you so much for watching the video.